Okay, there is a small correction that I want to make. Okay, so I by mistake I did cpy this and cmu this, which is wrong. The correct representation is cmu and cpy. In most of the, actually it doesn't matter what naming you will give, but in most of the books you will see this one. Okay, so I did a mistake. I wrote cmu this one and cpy this one, whereas it is cpy this one and cmu this one. Okay, so hope you will accept this small correction, and whatever miller you will apply, you will apply you to cmu, not cpy. Okay, because most of the textbooks you will see this representation of cpy in this between base and emitter, and cmu between base and collector. Okay, so this is the correct representation, this is the wrong representation. Okay, so whatever the analysis we have done, so if you will break the Miller, use the Miller theorem, then CMU 1 minus AV here between base and emitter, and here CMU 1 minus 1 by AV. Okay, and this is base, collector, emitter, and rest everything you know, right? So that's the small correction I wanted to make. Okay, now just to differentiate the model, this, let's say this is an example. R1, RC, R2, there is a NPN transistor, VIN, capacitor 1, capacitor 2, RL, RC. Okay, so you can see you have three different models. Just to have a clear picture in your head, this is the midband small signal model, where VIN is there, this capacitor C1, C2 is shorted, and these capacitors are open. Internal capacitance are these ones, external capacitance are these ones. Okay, if you will have a bypass capacitor, that is also comes under external capacitor. External capacitor means outside transistor. Internal capacitor means which are provided inside the transistors. Okay, so these are capacitors, base and emitter, base and collector. Okay, so this is what we will see. So here in small signal model, these two are, these are open, these are short. So you have this small signal model. For high frequency, what will happen? These will be short, but these won't be open. Okay, so V in RB, IB, beta RE, CPI, CMU, beta IB, RC parallel RL. Okay, the structure is similar to this, but you have extra capacitors. Okay, this CPI is between base and emitter, base and emitter, and CMU is between base and collector, base and collector. Okay, so this is the difference in the small signal models. Then in low frequency you will see this is high frequency. In low frequency what will happen, these capacitor won't be short, but these will be open, internal capacitors will be open. Okay, so you can see that when the capacitors will come into picture, they won't come into picture in midband region. External capacitors come into picture when you will deal with low frequency analysis, and internal capacitors will come when you will do the high frequency analysis. Okay, so that is the difference in models. So we have seen this part, we have seen this part. Okay, although we have not solved it directly, we were calculating the FLs corresponding to capacitors, and then we were plugging in the equation A mid divided by under root 1 plus FL divided by F tech. Okay, but here also we will do the same thing. So it's a it behaves as a high pass filter, it behaves as a low pass filter. So we will see how to calculate it. Now one thing I want to mention here, that whenever you use Miller effect on CMU, that is this capacitor, you will require this gain. If you remember, this CMU will be divided into CMU 1 minus AV in this direction between base and emitter, and there will be one more CMU. There will be one more CMU 1 minus 1 by AV. Okay, this if you remember, if you will apply Miller into this, but this AV is required, okay? So this AV you will calculate from midband region, okay? This is not the AV with the capacitor, it is AV without the capacitor, okay? Midband analysis gain you plug here. So that is one thing you have to remember. So it requires the analysis of midband. So here if you will see, the AV value will be, if you will use this, AV will be minus beta RC parallel RL, and IB is beta RA. So beta beta IB, so this will be IB, and IB will be VI by IB is equal to VI, so that will come under gain VI divided by beta RA. Okay, so this beta will get cancelled. So this will be your AV which you will plug here. Okay, this I got it from midband gain. This is what I wanted to mention. So it requires the analysis of midband gain because you will be utilizing this in Miller effect for this capacitor. Okay, so and now we will see another means like example where we will plug the value of this and you will get to know, we will get the feel of how to use the high frequency model. Okay.